And we'd like to welcome our brothers back to Winnipeg. With this selection in the 2011 entry draft, we're pleased to select Tyler Biggs from the U.S. National Development Program.
He is mean, he is nasty, and he's a whole lot of getting in your face.
I'll put it this way, I'm looking at my notes on him. Toughest player in the draft, most physical player in the draft, best fighter in the draft. Captain of the U.S. under 18 team, big power forward who can score some goals and get the ugly goals and go to the net. And a real big, strong kid, almost 6'2", 205 pounds. Some of the scouts I talk to say that he compares favorably to Milan Lucic in terms of his ability to play a physical game, but also score some goals.
Well, you get an idea of what he can do, not just with his toughness, but also with his skill level. He's not exactly unskilled. He can make a difference because of his strength, his skating ability, and his desire. Here's a good little play by him, getting the puck out front. Nice finish. Again, domination down low. Biggest thing about this player, his dad played in the National Hockey League, so it's tough. But when I look at it, he's going to Miami of Ohio. He's going to Miami of Ohio. Connor Murphy's going to Miami of Ohio. Ryan Burke's late son, Brendan, went to Miami of Ohio.
Absolutely. There's a strong connection there with Enrico Blasi. This will not be a situation where the team, I wouldn't think, would go to the player and say, we'd like you to play major junior hockey. Tyler Biggs, Ontario Hockey League rights are owned by the Oshawa Generals, the second-round pick of the Generals. There's a strong connection to the Generals there because Tyler's dad, Donnie Biggs, was a huge scoring star in the Ontario Hockey League. He was an AHL MVP after he played in the Ontario Hockey League. Tyler was born in Binghamton, New York, where Donnie Biggs was a player in the American Hockey League. And Donnie Biggs has settled in the Cincinnati area where he coaches a junior hockey team there. He's in sales. And Tyler Biggs, a big, strong guy. Played his minor midget hockey in Toronto. He played for the North York Junior Canadians in minor midget. And as I said, he had a big under 18 tournament. He scored the game-winning goal against Canada
right
in overtime to knock Canada out at the under 18 tournament in April.
Worth noting though that the Maple Leafs traded for John Michael Lyle today, who's an American, hired two American assistant coaches this week, and now have drafted an American with their first round pick.
Dave Poulin, the man all the way on the left, he was a coach at Notre Dame, obviously a very good pro player with the Philadelphia Flyers and the Boston Bruins, but he's had significant influence. You look at Toronto, they're not afraid to go into the U.S. college ranks. But again, I think that familiarity with Miami of Ohio. And Bob, here's what you were talking about with Tyler Biggs.
Yeah, here's the game-winning goal in overtime against Canada to send the U.S. to the gold medal game against the Swedes. So he's got some offensive touch to go with the physical play. The U.S. under 18 team plays in the United States Hockey League. And if you look at comparison between what Donnie Biggs did in his draft year back in Minnesota in 1983 versus drafted by Minnesota back in 1983. And look at the size difference. I mean,
it's unbelievable.
As I said, the U.S. under 18 team was competing in the USHL. He had five or six fights in the first five or six games of the USHL season. And the guys with the U.S. under 18 program would say, hey, you got to settle down a little bit here. We want you to work on your skills. We know you can fight. And he's going to go to college hockey, and there's no fighting in college hockey to speak of. And he's going to work on his skills and all of those other aspects of his game, get a little bit of rest. I don't think his fighting skills will erode too badly. It never hurt Chris Nyland or George Parros or Kevin Westgarth or a lot of other guys.
All right, here's James Duffy.
With Tyler Biggs and Brian Burke, general manager of the Toronto Maple Leafs. First of all, we were looking at that graphic comparing you size-wise to your dad, Donnie. When he played at 5'8", how exactly did you end up this large?
Honestly, just a little bit of luck. You know, we have some tall uncles in our family, but, you know, those extra few inches definitely didn't hurt.
The man on the left of you likes to throw around words like truculence and pugnacity and testosterone. Is that a fair way to describe the way you play hockey?
I try to, yeah, I guess you could say that, definitely.
Now, you played some in Toronto, so you know the intensity of this market.
Right.
So what does it mean to you to be a Toronto Maple Leaf? Wasn't it one of your favorite teams?
It is, yeah. I grew up watching them. All my family's from Toronto, so I grew up watching them, and it's just, you know, right now it's still a big whirlwind right now, and it's a dream come true.
Brian, this one is almost too obvious for you. Isn't this exactly your type of hockey player?
Yes, it's exactly the type of player we're looking for. We like hostile players, and this is a hostile player, but he's got skill too. We think Tyler's a guy that can play and contribute physically.
Now what? You obviously moved up to get him. You're sitting at 25, two picks away. Do we expect to see you there?
We'll see. We've got a bunch of offers for that pick. One includes an active player, so we'll see.
You had a bunch of trades working, you told me about yesterday. I assume one of those was John Michael Lyles. Was that one of them you were working on? And what does he bring to your team?
Well, I think we got a puck-moving defenseman, a 45-point raise last year, which is respectable. He's got good wheels. He's a great kid. I think it'll help our power play and help our puck-moving skills.
Are there any other balls still in the air?
Yes.
Anything close?
I don't know.
All right. Brian Burke, the general manager of the Toronto Maple Leafs, who we may or may not see just a couple of picks away. Congratulations.